I always had a lot of confidence. When I negotiated my contract with Bill Torrey, they weren't offering me enough money, so my agent said, why don't you tell him you're gonna score 50 goals?
Michael turned to me and he said, what is a 50-goal scorer worth to you? And I said, are you telling me you're gonna score 50?
He sort of looked at me and said, maybe you should make the team first before you say you're gonna score 50 goals.
Mike Bossy, the purest goal scorer of his generation, averaged an NHL record 0.76 goals per game during his relatively brief 10-season career. Drafted 15th overall in 1977 by the New York Islanders, expectations were high for the Montreal native.
He had the big afro hair, and he looked like a skinny kid, but he was incredibly well-developed. We had had a couple of years where we were tough to score against, but we just didn't have that dynamic offensive side to us. And there came Mike Bossy.
I knew once I made the Islanders, if I could just play with the right people, I could score.
At Bossy's first training camp, Coach Al Arbour paired him with centerman Brian Trottier. Together, they blossomed, remaining line mates for much of the next decade.
Brian befriended me, and everything just started to fall in place.
Probably my best friend on the team, like, for 10 years. We roomed together.
They tried to separate us once, and we made sure that we were back together.
They always knew where the other guy was going to be.
For Trotche, going in, 2-on-1. Shoots his goal!
If Trotche is in the corner, and he's got his head down, and he ends up getting the puck, he knew where Bossy was going to be without looking.
You need that chemistry. You need that one guy or those two guys that are going to push and pull each other. And we did that.
Bossy made good on his promise to Bill Torrey, scoring a then-record 53 goals as a rookie, winning the Calder. He scored 69 goals during his second campaign, his first of five 60-plus goal seasons.
One mistake on Michael Bossy is one goal against. He had an uncanny ability to get open.
How do you defend a guy like that?
I change. Get off the ice.
He had a terrific shot. He had a cannon of a shot, accurate, and he could change it up.
One day I said, boss, what are you thinking on your breakaways? And he said, when I come down, I look five hole, and I actually take my blade of the stick and take the puck and turn it on its side to see if I can put it through the five hole, through his pads. To this day, I've never seen anybody that could do that or has tried to do that.
On January 24th, 1981, Bossy stood poised to equal a record that at that time had only been achieved by Montreal Canadiens legend Maurice Rocket Richard, 50 goals in 50 games.
I ended up having 48 goals in 47 games and didn't score in the next two games, so I went into the 50th game needing to get two goals. First two periods without a goal, and finally I picked up a rebound on a power play we had, scored 49, and then a broken play.
Bossy shoots, he scores!
That spring, the Islanders won their second of four consecutive Stanley Cups. During their dynasty, Bossy led playoff goal scorers for three straight postseasons, scoring cup-winning goals twice, and was awarded the Conn Smythe Trophy in 1982. Beginning with his rookie year, Bossy scored more than 50 goals for an astounding nine consecutive seasons, an NHL record that might never be broken. The only time he didn't scale such statistical heights was in his final season, when he was diminished by a chronic back injury that would lead to his early retirement at age 30.
I didn't want to be ordinary. I didn't want to go out and only play half the games because of my bad back. Not playing the way that I knew that I could was just discouraged me to the point where I said, I'm not going to play anymore.
His career might have been cut short, but while he was on the ice, few dominated like Mike Bossy.